This video tutorial I will explain how to enable role-based security for REST API endpoint using JAX-RS Annotations. Here you can see database. In this example, we will use MySQL database. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application, which exposes REST API endpoints for create the employee record, update the employee record, get the employee record, delete the employee record, and get list of employee records. And we will see how to enable role-based security for these endpoints using JAX-RS annotations. Example of JAX-RS annotations are permit all, roles allowed, or deny all. And here you can see Postman client. Using Postman client, we will consume the RESTful web services which are exposed by this Spring Boot demo application. In this example, we are going to build RESTful web services using Jersey. So we have to include the dependency of Jersey in the pom.xml like this. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application with folder structure. And here you can see pom.xml file. Here you can see employee table and it has two records. Here you can see application.properties file, and here I have defined driver class name, URL of the database, and username and password of the database. Using this information, the Spring Boot application makes connection to the MySQL database. Here I have defined a class employee, and in this class I have applied entity annotation, and this class has four properties: ID, name, age, and salary. And in ID property, I have applied generated value annotation. So this ID value will be automatically generated by Hibernate. Here I have defined a class employees, and it has employees property and getter and setter methods for this property. In this example, we are using JPA. So I have defined interface employee repository, which extends CRUD repository. Here I have defined the interface employee service. It has create employee, update employee, get employees, delete employee, and is employee exist abstract methods. Here I have defined a class employee service symbol, which is service component, and it implements employee service interface and provide implementation of all the abstract methods. Here I have defined a class security filter, and in this class I have applied provider annotation, and this class implements container request filter interface and provide implementation of filter method. I will explain what is the use of this security filter. So what the security filter will do is it will examine the incoming request and fetch the authorization information. In this example, we will use basic auth authorization. So it will fetch username and password, and then security filter will check whether username and password is valid. If it is valid, then it will check the user role. And if the user role has permission, then it will allow to access the API. Else, it won't allow to access the API and it will deny the response. Here I have defined a class employee resource, and it has a create employee method, and it accepts employee object. This method is responsible for creating an employee record in the employee table. And to call this method, we have to send request to this path, and HTTP method should be post. And this method consumes JSON. And in this method, I have applied roles allowed annotation and passing role as admin. So this API endpoint can only access by the user who has role as admin. Otherwise, the user cannot access. This will be checked by the security filter. Here I have defined a class jersey config, which extends resource config. And here we have to register both employee resource and security filter. Here I have defined a class application, which is Spring Boot application. I am starting the Spring Boot application. Using Postman client, I am going to send employee create request. Here is the URL, and HTTP method is post. Click on header. Content type should be application/JSON. Click on body, and we have to select raw, and we are going to send JSON. So I have selected JSON here, and here you can see the employee object in JSON format. And in this example, I am going to use basic auth authorization. So select basic auth, and username and password I have given here. Username is admin and password is password. Click on send. The request reaches the security filter. The username and password is correct, and user has the role admin, so it reaches this method. And here we got the output. Employee is created successfully with the primary key 3. Click on refresh, and here you can see one record is created. Next, we will send wrong username and password, and we will see what will happen. username and password is wrong, so access will be denied. Here we got the output 404 not found because username and password is not correct. Here you can see get all employees method, and this method is responsible for getting all employee records from the employee table. And to call this method, we have to send request to this path. And HTTP method should be get. And this method produces JSON. And in this method, I have applied permit all annotation. So any user can access this endpoint. Next, I am going to send request to get all the employees. Here is the URL and method should be get, and username I can give anything. I am giving ROM and password as 123. Click on send. It reaches security filter. It has not done any validation because permit all annotation is there for the particular method. So it reaches here. And this method returns all the employees. Here we got the output. Here you can see delete employee method which accept ID. This method is responsible for deleting an employee record based on the given ID. And in this method, I have applied deny all annotation. So no one can access this endpoint. Next, I am going to send delete request given ID as 3. And HTTP method should be delete. Click on send and it reaches security filter. The method has deny all annotation. So access will be forbidden. So nobody can access the delete endpoint. Here we got the output 404 not found because the particular delete endpoint we have applied deny all annotation. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.